In this session, we will see how to configure MySQL master slave replication using bin log position. First, we need to enable bin log in master server and configure the server ID in master and slave. The server ID should be unique. For example, if you are setting one in master, you can set some other number in slave, for example, 2. Next step is create a user with replication slave privileges in master. This user is used to read the binary logs from master server to slave, and it will be used in configuration of replication. Next is backup the database. We can use any tools to take the backup. Here we are using MySQL dump. Next, restore the database in slave. Finally, configure the replication. Configuration includes finding the bin log coordinates from the backup file that will be available in backup. Then run the change master command. And then start the replication. Let us see the steps one by one. To enable binary log, we need to modify the configuration file. The parameter log-bin is a read-only parameter, so we need to change that parameter in configuration file. Post the changes, we need to restart the service. Path of the configuration will be /etcmy.cnf in most of the Linux distribution. Parameter name is log-bin, and this is the path of the binary log, and this is the prefix of the binary log names: masterdb-bin will be the prefix, remaining is the path of the binary log. Server ID I am setting as 1. Saving the file, restarting the service. Done. I'm going to that path. Binary log is created. As we told, the prefix would be the name whatever we have given. For that, it will be a running sequence number. Whenever new log is created, this number will be incremented. Next, we will change the server ID in the slave server. Here I have the server name, the host name MasterDB. Slave will have the host name as SlaveDB. That is for easy identification. Guys, you need to note one more thing. If you are changing the path of the apart from the default path, varlib MySQL to some other path, and AC Linux is enabled, it won't allow the MySQL service to start. Hence, you need to disable the AC Linux, or you need to add the AC Linux policy. Also, if you are using MySQL version 8, binary log is enabled by default, so no need to enable. The changes in the configuration, if you want to change the path, you can change in the configuration. Next, we are going to create a user for replication. That has to be done in master server. I am logging to MySQL. Creating the user. The user should have the privilege replications layer. Before that, I am using MySQL version 8. So I am giving this password plugin. Otherwise, it will take the plugin of the MySQL 8, that is caching SHA-2 password. If you are using that plugin, it is mandatory to configure SSL for replication. Otherwise, replication will report the error and it won't start. So for the reason, I am using this plugin, MySQL native password. User is created. I'm granting replication privilege, replication slave privilege for that user. It's done. You can verify. It's done. Next. If you want to verify the binary log changes, we can just query the global variables. Login is on. Base name is the path we have given. Server ID. We'll check server ID. Back up the database. We are going to take the backup of the database. Here I am using MySQL dump utility. Here one of the important parameters we need to use is -fn master data. That will capture the bin log coordinates that can be used for replication configuration. If you give -fn master-data equal to 1, the change master command which comes in the backup dump is not commented. If you are giving 2, it will be commented. Copying the backup to the slave server. Slave server IP is 102. Next, restoring the backup. We have already copied the backup to slave server. Now we are going to restore the backup. Restoration by using client utility MySQL. Restoration done. Next step, configuring the replication. Final step. First is finding out the bin log coordinates. Just read the first 50 lines, grab the change master command. See, it is commanded -fn. If you are giving -fn master -data equal to 1, this command won't come. Okay, capture this line in a node text file. Okay. Update the remaining things. Master fn host equal to IP of the master server. Master-user equal to username you have created, rep user. Master underscore password is the password we have used while creating the user. Who is default? You can specify or no need to specify since it is a default port. Let us run in the MySQL prompt. Slave server. Before starting the slave, let us check the slave status set. Now, here you can see two threads, slave IO, slave SQL. The IO thread is responsible for reading the binary logs from the master server to the slave. SQL thread will read IO thread will read the binary logs from master and it writes in the relay logs of the slave. SQL threads reads the events from the relay log and it will apply in the slave server. So let us start the replication. Start slave. Then again we are checking the status. Previously it was running no, it is running yes. Also, you need to check the seconds behind master. If the value is 0, it shows that it is perfectly synced with the master. If you are doing these steps in a production server, maybe backup will take around 5 hours, 6 hours, and restoration it will take 12 hours. So, while starting the slave, so the seconds begin master will show some bigger number. That means that much seconds it is lagging from the master. So it will take some time to catch up with master. Once it is completely synced with master, the values become zero. That's all in this session. If you have any queries, you can write it in comments. Thank you.